Now, CDN is a fantastic content delivery capability, but from security DDoS protection, it's suboptimal. By that means that it's not a total solution. It has some challenges. There's five broad categories of challenges with CDN. They are dynamic attacks. So dynamic attacks are the areas where you're calling a website, the CDN, for content that needs to be fresh. That means that the CDN needs to reach back to your specific servers for fresh content. This is the dynamic part of the website. And that reach back causes an opportunity, and in fact an empirical evidence, of attacks. We can clearly see evidence over the last 2 years of increased attacks on dynamic calls through CDNs. The second base is SSL-based attacks. Clearly, if you have the opportunity to encrypt a session between your CDN and your infrastructure, it can be obfuscated. In addition, if you hand a private key so that you can actually decrypt to your environment, you're actually causing your keys to be offloaded to outside of your environment, and you lose control of your keys. Either way, the SSL problem is a very big blind spot within the CDN infrastructure. The third is non-HTTP services. Clearly, CDN is focused on HTTP, and the attacks are focused on however they can get to you. That can be FTP, that can be SMTP, that can be VoIP or SIP-based protocols. Any other opportunity on layer 7 attacks is available that's around the CDN services that you're receiving. In addition, the CDN doesn't cover all of your IP block ranges. That's a very typical deployment. And when you have IP blocks that are not covered by your CDN, they're addressable and accessible by an attacker. We call those direct IP attacks. So we can actually attack you through your IP that's not covered through the CDN-based services. And the fourth are web application attacks, directed attacks, vulnerability-based attacks, attacks that can be sophisticated, and the protection sets on a CDN are going to be very generic. Why? Necessarily so. CDNs are large in scale, which means they cannot provide for intimacy of a protection set for your environment. So the potential for injections, for sessions problems, parameter tampering, SQL injections, all sorts of directed HTTP application-oriented attacks. So in summary, the five blind spots are dynamic attacks, SSL attacks, non-HTTP-oriented attacks, IP-based attacks, and web application-directed attacks. These are all represent blind spots within the CDN infrastructure.